Hi, I'm Erik Fox-Jackson, Interactive Learning Designer in the Faculty Center for Professional Excellence, and today we're going to be talking about ChatGPT. I have to admit, when I first heard about the possibility that my students could be using AI to complete their assignments, I was really scared and really worried about what that meant for my course and learning in my course. Would students just give up on learning altogether? And I was really scared. And then I started to think about it, and if students can use it, they already have access to it, then real jobs will be using it, right? Companies are already adopting AI or building their own AI data sets. And then I started thinking, should I be using this? Should I be adding this into my class and implementing this in my course? And now I'm of the mindset, yeah, I should start using AI in my course because it'll undoubtedly be something that's getting used in the future anyway. So maybe this semester I'm going to start using AI to synthesize points for my students when they have major questions that, you know, would take me some time to answer. I can feed that to the ChatGPT chatbot and it can give me back information for my students that I can verify and send over to them. Therefore, I can help my students out as much as they want me to be there for them, but then at the same time, not put all that work onto me. I can do all those things that I always want to do for my students, but I'm always too overwhelmed to be able to do. Maybe I can feed my assignments to the chatbot and see what comes out so I have an understanding of how my assignments look to other people. Maybe I can feed the reading to the chatbot and easily get a bulleted list to start off with to give my students for takeaways for the reading. And you know what? If AI can truly write their essays, then maybe we need to rethink the essay. Maybe we need students to generate essays through ChatGPT and then have the students evaluate the meaning and correctness of the information, because the information isn't always right. Sometimes ChatGPT makes up their references. And so have the students go in and verify the references, verify that the information cited there is correct. And if you don't want to bring AI into the classroom, I totally understand. I'm still a little hesitant to do it. You can just start implementing larger scale assignments that ChatGPT and other generators can't do. They can do non-scripted presentations, video essays, create ebooks, apps, brochures. They can design their own assessments that you co-create together. But I think by using AI in class, you can help your students understand how and when AI is an appropriate solution. Because like I said, it's here to stay. One thing we want to stress to our students is when to know the fundamentals and when to know information that's important. Because first of all, you can't use ChatGPT on the job when communicating with your boss or clients. Also on top of that, understanding the information better will help you prompt the AI better. Here's an example of why it's important to know the fundamentals. The image prompted on the left is just a simple prompt of man in a suit, whereas the image on the right applies the fundamentals learned from research and experience, as well as taking coursework in art, to write a detailed prompt to get a more robust, creative, interesting image. And without having an understanding of the content that you're feeding into the AI, you won't have an understanding of why what's coming out isn't quality. Also, make sure your students understand ChatGPT content can be flagged as plagiarism. The AI learns and extrapolates information from pre-existing data. So at times it could decide that the best possible solution is this existing piece of text, and it will plagiarize the information. So I'm not as scared anymore. I think I can use the AI to better teach my students and do the best by them that I can. As much as I don't want to admit it, the technology is here to stay. And it's probably going to change every job as we know it. And we want to better prepare our students for that future. And we can only do that by better preparing ourselves.